Hello everyone, this is MJ with MinIO. Here we are back in the lab environment in this case, and we're going to be deploying a single node, single drive MinIO with Docker Compose. Real quick, before we jump into the lab environment, I want to talk about the steps that we're going to walk through in this lab, just so you can have kind of a clearer picture in your mind of what we're going to do here. First thing we're going to do is create a local directory to mount our storage. So this is a local directory on the host that will map into a directory inside the container. Next, we're going to create a MinIO configuration file for the MinIO service to use that basically defines the username and password and the path inside the container where MinIO will try to store its data. Next, we will create the Docker Compose file with all the configuration items needed to bring up this Docker MinIO stack. We will deploy the stack using Docker Compose, and then we're going to check the logs using the Docker Compose logs command. And then we're going to log into the web UI and just make sure that everything works as expected. So let's jump into the lab environment. So here we are in the lab environment, and the first thing we need to do is to create a directory on the host for the container to map to. So in this case, we're going to call it mount data compose. This is important to note because this needs to be the same inside your Docker Compose file. So we'll go ahead and get that created. Next thing we need to do is to create the MinIO configuration file. And I will simply paste it from my notes here. We will leave a link in the description. So you can go and get a sample of this file yourself. There's lots of other options that you could define here, but in this case, we will just use these basic options. And next we need to create the Docker Compose file. So we'll go ahead and nano Docker Compose. And again, you would be storing this likely in some sort of source code repository. So you'd be able to pull this in from GitHub or something like that. And here we are with the options that we defined before in the slides that we talked about. Please feel free to pause your screen and review these if you'd like, but these are the same as they were in the previous slides. Note down here that why I said it's important to name the things on the local host properly. At the bottom here, you can see the volumes. We are mounting mount data compose into mount data inside the container. If that does not exist on the host operating system, it will not work as you expect it to. Same goes for the configuration file. That is located at etc default minio, and we're mounting it inside the container at etc config.env. Go ahead and exit out of here. And now, just that quickly, we are ready to actually bring this up and online. So if we do docker compose up -t, we can see that it's going to go ahead and look for that container image locally. If it doesn't find it, it will automatically pull that down. And now it should be up and running. And we will do docker compose logs. And we can see here that it has brought the server up online. There are no errors showing here. It does warn you that minio admin is not the recommended username and password. But as I said before, please make sure you make that something more secure than this. And again, just as before, when we were running this from the Docker CLI, note that the IP addresses shown here are the IP addresses of this container, not of your host. So you need to know your host IP if you want to be able to access this. In my case, my host IP has already been defined, so I'll go ahead and open up a browser tab so that you can see that. And here we are at the MinIO console address. We'll go ahead and log in with the MinIO admin username and password that we defined in the configuration file. And you can see that it looks like MinIO is working as expected, but let's just make sure. We're gonna go ahead and create a bucket and call it docker compose test. And we can create that bucket. You can upload a file into this bucket. And we will just go in here and grab one of my test files. And that uploaded quickly. And we can see that it's showing here in the web UI. And now if we go back over to our lab box, if we do a tree on slash mount, we can see that the mount data compose directory is there. It also created a new directory called docker compose test, which correlates to our bucket. And we can see that 10 meg file in there as expected. So that's how easy it is to get things up and running with Docker Compose. You can see it's a lot less management from the perspective of having to manage all those CLI commands versus having to manage a single YAML configuration file. It's more easily editable. Hopefully this has taught you something about learning how to deploy MinIO with Docker Compose, and we will see you next time. Thanks.